Command interface initiated.
Hello, greetings, welcome back. I decided here in Battletech to take one more mission on the planet we were at. It's a four skull contract, regular battle mission in an urban environment. So, should be the usual thing of possible reinforcements. Yeah, thank you, Darius. Then we got friendlies. Friendlies over here. Expect that I'll come back in one piece. Okay, so we get a bonus if our friendlies survive. Okay. Look, so the friendlies also seem to have the alphabet issue. Catapult, catapult, catapult. And we immediately, before we even had a chance to move once, we are now in combat, and the first enemy already moved. Cool, what do we have? Two unknowns and a 70 Don Mac. I'm assuming that that is the one that already moved. Yeah, screw everything about that, we're just gonna let them have the first turn and then we'll decide what we do. Come on, anyone here? Okay, Cataphract. Ooh, are these enemies with reduced armor rating? Yeah, I... think they are like 75% rating. Man, the camera has gone wild here. That's awesome. Okay, so let's see if we wanna join. Do I wanna play here? Got all the shots in the world. I guess that grasshopper is probably the best target.
Acknowledged. Confirmed.
Oh, he's not having a good day.
Scored critical hit.
Standing by.
Right. There's no chance in hell that you can get anything useful down here this turn. So let's just sprint. Do I want to get ice on the awesome? Yeah, maybe we can ghost rifle him a little bit.
No shooting, just running. Got it. Receiving you.
Okay, same thing for you. You can't get in range of anybody. Kinda would like to, you know, be in cover. Maybe.
Standing by.
Maybe you do, we'll do this first. You know the drill, right? Go for the ice, boo. Go for the ice.
Hope we can salvage that.
Yes, I'm fairly certain we can.
Commander?
Okay, and that way I can be actually in cover completely here.
Understood. Moving fast.
Okay, enemy reinforcements. And we get warned a turn early. Not by Darius. So it's like, okay. What even is Darius' job here?
Waiting for orders.
You know what? I think I'm just gonna stay behind the building and keep
aye, aye.
A very, very indirect angle. And keep shooting that guy.
Think I hit something good.
I think we'll be able to save all of these guys because they are moving kind of in a dumb way.
Good to go. Position confirmed.
That's not the best shot I've ever had. Feels a bit like a waste of a precision strike, but no, no buts. Let's shoot someone else then. No, actually, let's go for the center torso. That's not quite the center torso.
Score! Critical hit.
Headbutt with a catapult. It's a long-range mech. Oh no, and now that guy is shooting in your back. Nobody could have expected that. Well, look at Mr. Multi-Target there.
Standing by.
Okay, I was kind of hoping that since the awesome came from there, that more enemies would show up on that side. It's not really happening.
Ready for orders. Engaging jump jets. Scored a critical hit.
Ready for orders.
Okay. How safe do I want to play it? Do I just want to get in there, or do I want to stay out of line of sight? I think we're going to go with the line of sight approach. Because reinforcements are incoming, right?
No retreat!
It's like enemy reinforcements. Did we know there would be reinforcements? Well, you told us last turn, right? It's like... Okay. So that's, what, Rifleman? Can't quite make it out from here. New targets are part of a contract, so need to take them down as well. No, it's a blackjack. Okay, let's have a quick look. A black knight, and a cataphract. Still staying in the good old ABC pattern here. I really want to take down that grasshopper one way or the other.
What's up, boss?
I think we're going to start with that. Yeah, not the most amazing shots because he has lots of evasion. But you know what? Fairly certain that's it's gonna be enough for him. Barely like the last last missile hit his center torso. Critical. Where did he jump to? Oh, you should really move that guy. Like the way the AI plays these catapults, that's just heartbreaking to see. Like, those are long-range mechs. and he's jumping around and going into melee. Talk about long range max and how much do I want evasion and how much do I want to stay in the back a little bit. Okay, keep killing those hats. I'll start killing those hats. Why did he not fire at all? That's odd.
Orders?
Okay, yeah, let's move in here.
Coordinates received.
And let's shoot some more on that guy.
Firing. Inflicted some heavy damage.
What a messy brawl there in the middle. Well, that almost looked smart, as if he wanted to stand in front of the guy to protect him. I don't give the AI that much credit. Sorry. Let's just get into the middle of the whole mess.
Got it.
But I want to be the first one out. And let's just finish off that guy.
Aye, aye.
Hostile removed.
Let's go. Let's go.
Did I ever do to you so that you should start shooting me? Unacceptable.
Standing by.
Okay, we can get the back. Yeah, let's do that. What I would like to call the grasshopper treatment. Hang on, game. You told me I was shooting in his backside. Like, it's showing me the back here, but in the called shot target, it's showing me a side shot. Like, make up your mind. That's the back. Excuse me? I don't get it.
Roger.
And we hit the back.
Take that.
Wow.
Losing lots of armor.
Yeah, let's get you out of there.
Ready.
That was like, there's so much going on there, and they shoot me. It's like, how's that fair? What did I ever do to them?
Roger.
That also looked like he's standing behind me, but he punched me in the side. But shoots me in the back.
System's holding.
Receiving you.
Yeah, I probably want to shoot on that guy. just sitting here shaking my head about the way I place the catapults.
Receiving you.
Okay, we seem to have a little bit of a I shoot you in the back, you shoot me in the back situation here. I can't get a back shot on that Black Knight.
Location confirmed.
So maybe we continue on the cataphract here. Make sure he doesn't do anything more nasty. Should I just... Yeah, that's precision strike. Okay. No, it's not giving me anything. Okay, just give me... Interfaces. Playing weird tricks on me today.
Here it comes.
Also, that autocannon did not hit center torso.
I think I hit something good.
It's an artillery mech. Okay, that's a little bit more damage than I would like to take on the grasshopper.
Internal structure damage. No retreat.
Okay, so Blackjack should move first. Really doesn't like my Orion. And then I should be able to move my hopper.
Commander.
And with 10 health on the leg, he's not going to be hopping that much longer. Does anything here count as forest cover? Not really. Okay, this is my right leg, right? Yeah. So that's angle like this, protecting my right side.
Jumping.
Yeah, that's also vigilance. And then shoot that guy.
I copy. Mech destroyed.
Good old center torso ammo. I'm amazed that they
damage
keep
minimal.
Shooting him. Like, that must be the worst target they could possibly get. Just from the two-hit chance. Also, how did they move two guys? They shot me? Oh no, oh, so that... It's the guy. He shot and then moved. Right.
Good to go.
How healthy are you? Oh, you are kind of... a little bit injured in the back.
Enemy down.
One more for the trash heap. Oh, so it's just that Black Knight and he already moved?
Ready for orders.
Firing all weapons.
Okay, so let me get that straight. That catapult just jumped right next to him and then fired its long-range missiles.
Orders.
Man, are they bad.
Giving him everything I've got. Enemy down.
That was rough, Commander. Well done. Yeah, it was rough to watch how these guys moved.
Mission successful.
Alright. A little bit of damage here, nothing too extreme. But this screen is the one that's gonna be interesting. Okay, so we can complete an awesome. Did we ever get a cataphract? Fairly certain we should have, because we are sitting on zero parts. They really just massacre everything else? And I don't have more salvage options, I think so. That might be interesting. I'm really wondering if I should consequently start picking up these plus 10 damage medium lasers and just replace everything on the grasshopper. I'm definitely going to pick up that small laser. Because going from 20 to 30, that's not just... That's a significant increase, right? Oh boy, look at all these arm mods. What is happening there? Coming back to the ideas what we can do with the faster-ish Banshee. It could build a pretty nasty puncher. A mech that can do nothing else, but when it punches, oh boy, you don't want to be in the way. Like, as far as I know, there's no limit how many arm mods you can install, right? So I can get 3 of those and have 180 more punch damage. Plus, I think Banshee does what? 110 already on its own? I have 2 of those already. Just install 5. Punch for 400. I'm gonna pick up 2 arm mods. I just need to see this through. And even if it's probably not gonna work because you can't reliably get into range for punching, but oh boy, once I'm there. Who needs weapons? Just arm mods. Okay, got a little bit of cataphract, nothing else on the salvage side. Got 1 of those 10 damaged lasers. And ooh, yeah, heat sinks. And heavy jump jets. No, we need assault jump jets for the Banshee.
That mech you wanted is back online.
Okay, yes, our macro is gaining experience. Probably talking about Dragon, who can pick up piloting 9, yes.
Mech warrior training complete.
Yes, Commander.
And eventually, I mean, you also have some XP to spend, so why don't we... What was it going for with Voodoo? Probably coolant vent. Maybe ace pilot. I'm not sure. Let's just do it like this. In theory, I like ace pilot a lot, but we really haven't used it at all recently. Because once you're up to assault mechs, etc. Can't really take that much advantage of this, I feel, anymore. Like, move in, shoot, and then first one next turn, shoot and move out again. Let's have a quick stroll to the mech bay. Okay, repair that. So, the awesome. It's basically, to be honest, it doesn't do at this point anything that the Banshee 3S can't do better. I guess I think an 80 ton mech can still use heavy jump jets, so that if I want him jump capable, it's easier. But like, if I want to build the stock awesome, which is the whole free PPC variant, why don't I just slap free PPCs on the Banshee and I have some additional tonnage to do something else? Alright. So the Banshee does 120, 130. Okay, so I think as much, I mean, awesome is awesome because it has an awesome name, and also I have fond memories of this mech just from playing the board game a lot. It was always a scary thing. And if you can't customize the mechs and just have to use the stock outfits, which is the way we usually played, this was just solid and had one of the highest armor values in the game. But in terms of what it does for us here is probably nothing. Well, maybe I need to check the lists whether or not it's significantly better than Orion. It's still gonna be slower, right? Because it has a movement of 3 instead of 4. But what I want to quickly check, yeah? Still haven't decided what to do with the slow Banshee, but now that we have all these fancy arm mods for 60 melee damage. Oh, I guess the limit is you can only install them in the arm, and they take up a lot of room. Yeah. The 51 is 6 slots, this one is also 6 slots, okay. So it's really just, oh, that's stability anyway. Yeah, but that's still gonna be a 250 punch. Definitely max armor, and let's pull back what? Like 3 here? Okay. Let's quickly check the store. Do I want some assault jump jets? I don't have any at the moment.
New equipment available.
Just gonna buy 4. Like, it's not like the money matters at this point. Which I wouldn't be able to fit anyway. So, option is I can put in some support weapons that also then fire when we punch. Which I think probably makes more sense than jump jets. Haven't done anything yet with flamers. I'm hesitant here because, yeah, small lasers are better in this case, but I don't want to take them away from proper mechs. Yeah, let's just pop for machine guns in here. Okay, lasers with 4 matons. and not much in the way of weapon slots. Put my medium pulse laser in here. It's not like I'm using it anyway, whatsoever. Throw that in there. Probably not bad, and that's it. I have 3 tons and really nothing useful to do here. I'm gonna just strip off a little bit of armor to be able to fit 2 jump jets, I think. Something like that. So it's then not the Banshee. It's more like the Punchy. Not sure if that works.
Right. I'll get it in the schedule.
Okay, cool. One other thing. I wanted to replace the medium lasers on the Grasshopper for the plus 10 damage variants. But it's now being... Okay, I think... Confirm. Let's go for the refit. Okay, I've got 5 of these. Moment, I'm all rocking accuracy and crit. So, yeah, let's get that stuff out of here. And while I'm at it, small lasers. Alternatively, since we do tend to have a little bit of heat problems, right? I could rip out the small lasers and just go with full machine guns. And I think I like that idea. Just go full machine gun here. Alright, do that.
Logged and noted. Shouldn't be too hard.
And yeah, I'm in mech building mood a little bit. I hope you don't mind. Let's turn our Banshee into a pseudo awesome, as in PPCs. Which, well, we do have. Do we have any good ones? Stability damage, accuracy, damage. Okay, if I were to pop in 3 of those, Just gonna get the armor to a reasonable number. Okay, so still 20 tons. That's so much heat though. 105 heat. Okay, we definitely want a heat exchanger. Right, we do have the double heat sinks, which I still haven't used on anyone else. Got four of those in the now. Didn't even realize that. Let's see how much we can get out of this. I'm not a fan of the heat banks. Like that, to me, that just seems to delay the problem and not solve it. Throw in a targeting computer. Although most of our shots are really awesome anyway, but yeah, gyro is free. Do we have any cockpit mods? Just rangefinders. Okay, not interested. I'm just gonna fill up the torso locations with heat sinks, and then we'll have a quick look what we do with the last 5 tons. So at this point, at just 22 heat, if we fire all PPCs. I'm just not sure. I feel like PPCs are not really worth it in the current version of the game in terms of heat versus damage. Or maybe we use them more for stability stuff, I don't know. I'm just thinking a 95 ton assault mech with just 3 PPCs doesn't seem super scary. And if I dropped 2 heat sinks and put a 4th PPC in, then we'll probably be in heat hell. If I want to really ruin things, I can do an extended range PPC in there. Let's see, that's 35 more heat. Now that's insane. I mean, the alternative is then to just fill it up with heat sinks. And then we can almost fire everything continuously. 3 PPCs every turn. The PPC. I'm not convinced yet.
On it. I'll let you know when that's done.
Anyway, I think it's time to leave this system behind. Let's head over to the star map. And I think because I don't trust the travel time predictions, I probably want to head over to Succession first. Because that's 63 days. Yeah, let's travel there.
Roger that, Commander. Course plotted.
And I'll leave you at the end of this episode with a little bit of... what's that? Oh yeah, you like me again. Just wait for the next time I drive across you. For a little bit of traffic, travel graphics, without any commentary. Of course we would get a random event. Speaking to Yang, Path McVerse fades off in front of Madmac. Dragon pulls back to throw a punch at Tarbox. No. Send them to the Livingston simulators. 50 experience. Oh no, low spirits, that sucks. It's like, really? With these numbers? Okay. I guess Dragon will not join any mission anytime soon. Low spirits is really bad. Keep flying.
Upgrades you asked for are online, Commander.
Okay, we got one more thing to do here. Taking care of ship upgrades. Our morale is maxed, so I think I'm gonna actually do the medbay upgrades first.
Sure thing. It'll take a bit, but we'll get it done.
Also, I just noticed. Don't we normally hear like intercom stuff? Like, oh, entering orbit, prepare for jump, etc. I feel like that's missing. I don't know. Let's continue traveling.
Job's done, Commander.
I've got the financial report.
Alright, and we're here for the succession flashpoint, but that's gonna be in the next episode. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.